Boston's for 3 days' time. Well, it isn't hard to stand aside and call somebody down, especially when that someone, he doesn't happen to be around. But there's an old, old saying that I'm trying to understand. Says to walk in his moccasins before you judge the man. Here we go. Well, one to walk in his moccasins for 3 long days. Look out through his eyes and try to see the look his way. I feel the pros and problems that the big play on his mind. And walk in his moccasins before you judge the man. You know, the weight upon one's shoulders may lay heavy on the mind. He may carry a patch it's hard to leave behind. I only wish that we might fit it in our plans to walk in his moccasins before we judge the man. Here we go. Yes, I want to walk in his moccasins for 3 long days. Look out through his eyes and try to see the look his way. Feel the troubles and the problems that may plague upon his mind. And walk in his moccasins for 3 days' time. Just try to walk in his moccasins for 3 days' time.
Well, other than a little bit of Pretty Woman, it's been all Alan Moberg songs. But I'm going to make an exception for Harry. He's going to sing an old... Well, you really baked me back there, Harry.
$50.
Yeah, well, $50 is $50. Anyway, is this an old song that Harry learned, I guess, in Ireland? And it's called The Blackboard of My Heart. So I'm going to try to harmonize with Harry.
That's fine.
And then we'll...
We can eat the therapy.
All right?
Yeah, I'm just having a row with the sound man. In Ireland, the sound man is a guy that's really good. You know, oh, jeez, he's a sound man. And Greg here is one of the soundest sound men I know.
We have a world-class sound man. When I went with George Hammond IV, he would say, this is for the unsung hero back on the sounds. There you are. Yeah. So we're going to do this old country song because Harry, every time I come to the treehouse, Harry shows up and we sing this together.
When I was young, I went to school. They taught me how to write. To take the chalk and make a mark and hope it turned out right. But that's the way it is with love and what you did to me. I wrote this so you know that I was yours eternally. And my tears are washed, I love you from the blackboard of my heart. It's too late to clean the slate and make another start. I'm happy now the way things are, although we're far apart. But my tears have washed, I love you from the blackboard of my heart. If you'd been true the way you should, not have run away. These tears I cry for someone else are tears that might have been. No need to talk, cause if the chalk should make this mark again, it would be for someone else and things that might have been. And blackboard of my heart. It's too late to clean the slate and make another start. I'm happy now the wings are, although we're far apart. My tears have washed I love you from the blackboard of my heart. My tears have washed I love you from the blackboard of my heart.
There's probably all kinds of things that I could say. You know, I just thank you for coming, and I mean, this is amazing. This has just been wonderful. I want to, I'm lucky enough to have two sons, and they're sitting together right there. The oldest is Leo, and the next is Doug. Would you guys stand up, please? We want to give a hand for Matthew. Thank you. I know how that's going to be. Thank you for that. Julie, who came out, she came by way of Alaska, I believe, to make it here. She was up in, was it Anchorage? Julie holds a very high position in Northern Health. And,
First Nations Health.
Well, I was trying to get in on that, but anyways, so it's wonderful. You saw my nephew and my grandniece. Yeah, that's right. Dean, and you know what Dean did? You know, I mean, he ended up playing the trumpet. And is your doctorate in performance trumpet? Am I right on that? Yes. Well, when he was just a little guy, he did pick up the guitar. One of my friends was over there. He said, "Are you going to play like guitar like Uncle Al?" He says, "Better." And his brother Russell is there, and Dylan is here. Little Dylan, right over there. So, anyways, I don't know how you want to do this, but this is years ago. You know, I'm old enough to remember when dances had home waltzes. Anybody here remember that? You're all keeping quiet if you do. Anyways, I wrote a song a while back, and when my wife heard it, she says, "You're not really romantic enough to sing a song like that." But it's mine anyways. It's called The Ganges Waltz. And there's a pardon? Yeah, Dion. Oh, yeah. Dion is, well, yeah, come on up, Dion. This is one of the guys who, yeah, maybe we could do that. Well, why don't we do that while they're setting up? Ed Peeketoot is not only a great guitar player, and he's also an artist. He paints, he carves, and I want to call Marilyn up. Are you still here, Marilyn? Are you here, Marilyn? Is there somebody here to receive it? Well, we'll put it somewhere, but this... Chris, you can, Chris there? We'll take Chris. Come on up, Chris. Ed Peeketoot. Come on, Chris. You just have to reach out and take it yourself. This is a carving of cottonwood bark done by our own Ed Peeketoot. And I want to present this to Chris and Marilyn. Maybe we'll find a place to sit around this in the store. So, you're welcome.